Is it possible to say, or is it too much cut and dry to say that, according to your theory, no profit sector has to be helped in order to help people? So it's not sufficient just to involve the non-profit sector and say we are building a new governance, which is very fashionable name. But you have to be aware of how to help through a public intervention to create mechanism in order to empower this system that otherwise is not able to properly work.
Yeah, I think I would accept that. I react a little negatively to the term helps. It sounds like it's a dependent. I would rather say that it's the responsibility of government to put this sector on a level playing field with respect to the resources that any entity would need in order to function effectively.
Yeah, but at the same time, sorry to interrupt you, to offer the guarantee, to create the mechanism, institutional mechanism, because it works.
I think it is. In my view, it would be the responsibility of government, if it wants to take advantage of this unique set of institutions, to guarantee that it has a level playing field to operate on and that it is as effective as it can be. In the very design of projects and programs, I think the third sector should be involved. If it's going to be called on to implement the program, it has knowledge of how things work on the ground that would be valuable in the design of programs. So don't call them in after you've already written the law and designed the program. Call them in when you're in the design stage and get input.
Yes, because otherwise, that's what we experimented sometimes in Lombardy. Otherwise, if you're not able to create this structure, this system, sometimes it happens that the no-profit sector, or let's say civil society, if there was, is right, sometimes they accept the simple role of delivering services, and they're not anymore subject or protagonist of new arena.
Mm-hmm.
And also the creativity aspect is going to lose their creativity. Well, there
are real dangers in creating dependency. I've always argued in this country that paradoxically, the nonprofits that are most involved with government are the most active as advocates. And we've got very powerful data that documents that. They do not lose their voice. And I think it's because, generally speaking, the contracting or voucher systems are politically neutral. That's a very high value in this country. It's not perfect by any means, but nonprofits know that when they criticize the public sector, they're not going to be penalized in the contracting process as a result of that. Now, how to achieve that culture is, of course, difficult, and in some countries it's impossible. But it's obviously a very important part of this whole new governance idea.
Yes, also it's part of the difference between a simple quasi-market or new public government or other theory like this. I think this is very close to the idea of subsidiarity that we try to improve, because subsidiarity is not just delivering services or the externalization of service or the contract system. It has to do more with the idea of a primacy of civil society and the possibility, as you said, of designing a program or to invent a program.
Right.
So in this respect, you're saying that also for a subsidiarity-inspired model, the attention to the tools and to institutional framework is decisive. It's not enough to deliver or to trust non-profit, but you
Right, and I think I have expressed to you this concern that sometimes when I look at the Lombardy model in operation, I think that it is closer to quasi-market than it is to subsidiarity. And I would love it to be more subsidiarity-oriented. And the difference is precisely that quasi-market essentially lets the market decide the outcome. And it does not explicitly take account of the structural disadvantages of the nonprofit sector in a market setting. So if you really value the nonprofits and what they can bring and what their special character is, then it obliges you to make the corrections to put them on an equal footing with for-profits. Otherwise, all your talk of subsidiarity will end up hurting the nonprofit sector, reducing its role and advantaging for-profits over time. And 20 years later, you'll wake up and the nonprofit sector will have shrunk to a fraction of its current size.
But what is true that in the new governance perspective, government has more to do than in the normal government. It doesn't mean, in other words, that in the new governors, the government has less to do and leaving society to do whatever they
Absolutely.
Want.
Absolutely.
It's more responsible and more active and more probably busy and tough job for the government.
Exactly. The argument of this Tools of Government book and the new governance is that this is not the public sector walking away. This is not privatization as it was perceived in the 80s. So I talk about three skills that are needed instead of top-down management. One of them I call activation, the formation of these networks. It's frequently the case that the government may create a loan guarantee thinking that the commercial banks will just jump up and down with joy, but the commercial banks say, no thank you, until they can be persuaded that it's in their interest. So somebody has to activate the network, and this is an act of persuasion and negotiation to find where it is that, how it is that you can get your third parties to get into the act. And then the second skill I call orchestration. So once people agree, you still have to get them working together. So I liken it, the metaphor is that of an orchestra conductor. So the conductor didn't write the music, doesn't play any instrument, but if you don't have a conductor in the orchestra, these professional musicians, they just make noise. They just make noise. So you have to have a conductor, and the public sector can play that role, can bring people to the table, but then it can get them working together. And then the final skill is what I call modulation, another musical analogy.
Has to do with tuning.
With tuning, exactly. So each one of these networks has people in it who have their own objectives. They may not share 100% the objectives of the public sector. Therefore, the public sector needs to bring a combination of rewards and penalties. And it has to modulate, it has to adjust them so that it gets the outcome that it wants without producing a windfall profit on the part of the private sector.
And probably education is a key role, plays a key
Absolutely.
Role in this.
Right. But not our traditional public administration. You know, we have still in this country, we have schools of public administration. They teach people
Are you saying we need a new way of schools for high officials
Absolutely.
And public administration?
Absolutely. I mean, the curriculum needs to change, whether we need a new school, but the curriculum needs to change. So right now we're teaching people how to run public agencies in the public administration profession, how to do budgeting in the public agency, how to do personnel recruitment and management in the public agency, how to do planning in a public agency. It's all assuming that you're running an agency that's delivering services. They get up there on the stage and they start issuing orders. That's not how you run an orchestra. And that's not how you run a collaborative network of
Yeah.
people involved in running your policy. And I think we don't have it right here, I can tell you. We backed into this without thinking about it. And one of the interesting features of the book is that once you say it and everybody says, ah, of course. Why didn't I think of that? But nobody was saying.
Professor Salamon, in conclusion, have you got any tips or suggestion for the regional government of Lombardy?
Yes, I think my suggestion would be to take as seriously the subsidiarity plank in your strategy as you take the quasi-market plank. The two are not wholly in harmony, and I fear that the quasi-market set of ideas has got more strength to it in the current policy choices that you've made than does the subsidiarity theme.
Thank you so much, Professor Salamon.
My pleasure.